Hi friends, and welcome back. We have done with three word families and have learned 18 new words so far. As you know that the fourth week has been started, so all the words that we are going to learn in this week are from D family. So today's word is demeanor. It spells like D-E-M-E-A-N-O-U-R, demeanor in British, and D-E-M-E-A-N-O-R, demeanor in American. So let's pronounce with me, demeanor, demeanor. The word is a noun and is defined as the way of person behaves towards other people. To illustrate more, demeanor refers to the social non-verbal behaviors such as body language and facial expressions that are characteristic of a person. Or in simple words, a person's demeanor is the distinguishing feature of his personal nature. In Urdu, the word demeanor is termed as zahiri andaz, taur tariq, waza, dhang, rakh rakhav, ye saluk. Demeanor in English today has evolved from Middle English and Old French to refer to the way one manages or presents oneself. And this definition applies to conduct as well as facial expressions. The way you present yourself often affects how others make judgment about you. And therefore, you might want your demeanor to reflect the situation you are in. So if you are at a birthday party, your demeanor should be happy and smiling. As far as the word's origination is concerned, there's a long trail from Latin minare, which means to threaten, and has been connected to the threatening cries of cattle drivers to English demeanor. Along the way, we first encountered Latin minare, it means to drive, and was once used specifically of driving animals for herding. From there, the path leads us to Anglo-French, where we pass by manner, to lead, and then demeanor, to conduct. Next comes Middle English demeanin, and then Modern English demean. Both meaning is to conduct oneself in a certain manner. And finally, we take one last step and add the suffix "-r", to demean, to get demeanor. Incidentally, the word demeanor carries a list of synonyms. Some of them are conduct, manner, appearance, attitude, and deportment. However, there is no such significant word that can be used exactly as its antonym. Despite the words like impropriety and indecency can be used in the pretty opposite sense. So now let's have a look on its usage in a sentence. The first example is, people are affected with their customs, traditions, religions, and social demeanor. The next example is, she has a demeanor and magnetism that attracts individuals and makes them feel very comfortable in her presence. And the last example is, the man's demeanor makes others suspicious of his intentions. So that's all for today. Keep practicing the word and please do share your views and feedback with us in the comments below. So see you tomorrow with a new word. Stay with us and have a nice day.